Today we will learn about different types of switch gears that are used in power system and principle of operation of a circuit breaker. What is meant by a power system? Power system largely equipped with many equipments like generators, transformers, transmission lines, distribution lines and many more substations. So to operate all these equipments or transmission lines or substations, so we need a switch gear system. What is meant by a switch gear? Switch gear means it is in a switching operation. For doing the maintenance, we have to shut down the transmission line or distribution line, or to switch on the power supply or to switch off the power supply, we need the switch gear. Let us have more details about the different types of switch gears. So before going into the switch gears, let us understand what is meant by a switch. Did you see what is this? This is nothing but a switch which is used in our schools, in our office buildings or in the houses to operate electric fans or electric lamps, fridges, etc. And what it does do, it is making a circuit and breaking in a circuit. When you close the switch, that means fan rotates, that means power supply goes to fan. When you open the switch, that means the fan does not rotate, so power is cut off only here. It has got two terminals, upper terminal and lower terminal. Lower terminal supply will be given. For upper terminal, supply will be taken to an apparatus. So when you close the switch, the supply will be cut off here only, the bottom. When you open the switch, the supply goes from bottom terminal to upper terminal, therefore apparatus runs. Let us see with the diagram. This is the circuit diagram. This is a lamp connected through switch to a battery. When it is connected to a battery, current passes to the lamp, but here the switch is open, therefore current will not pass to the lamp, therefore lamp does not glow because switch is open. See, in this case the lamp, again it is connected through the switch to the source. When it is connected to the source, battery source, the supply goes. Now here the switch is closed, therefore current passes from the switch to the lamp and again returns back to the source. Therefore here the circuit is closed through the switch, hence the lamp glows. So what does the switch is doing here? When switch is making the contact, lamp glows. When switch breaks, lamp does not glow. So basically the switch is used either to close or open an electrical circuit. Let us discuss more about different types of switch gears. The types of switch gears are air brake switches, knife switches, isolators, circuit breakers. The types of switch gears: air brake switches, knife switches, isolators, circuit breakers. All these switches makes only one purpose, either it makes the circuit or it breaks the circuit. But according to the need and where these switch gears will be used, in that way they have been named as isolators, knife switches, circuit breakers, etc. Let us discuss more about the AB switch. What is the air brake switch? It is operated under full load conditions, designed for low currents, manually operated, used in pole mounted substations. Regarding the air brake switch, we have studied in second year estimating class. AB switches are used in pole mounted substations to switch on and switch off the pole mounted substations, and these switches are used for full load conditions, but they are manually operated and they do not have any rupturing or making capacity. These AB switches, for each pole it has got two insulators. So that is for single phase. For two phase or for single phase neutral, it will have a 4 insulator, and for 3 phases, it will have a 6 insulators. So all these 3 poles, simultaneously it opens, simultaneously it breaks the contact. Let us see how it operates with the circuit diagram. This is a air brake switch. It has got 2 insulators, forced insulators mounted on a channel, and one insulator rotates about its axis 90 degrees vertically, and one insulator, this is a fixed, this cannot be movable, it cannot rotate, but it rotates, this insulator rotates 90 degrees about its axis, and it has got an operating rod which connects from this metallic part to this metallic part. Over the insulator there is a metallic part to receive the supply. So one insulator metallic part is connected to a supply, the other insulator metallic part is connected to a load. When it operating handle makes with this metallic part, that means supply is going from this insulator to this insulator, therefore the apparatus runs. And suppose we want to switch off, so this is connected in turn to an handle, vertical handle system. When the handle is moved, immediately this operating rod moves away, therefore isolation break makes in between these two insulator, thus the equipment will be isolated. So this is called horizontal brake air brake switch. And the other one is double brake AB switch. Here the either side of the two insulator posts, they are fixed, and this insulator, it is a rotating one, and it has got an operating system, and the supply is given to one of the insulator this side, and the supply will be taken from this side, or it can be used for multi-purpose. The supply is given to the middle insulator operating rod, and the supply can be two-way supply can be taken from this insulator to this insulator. So when it breaks, this insulator rotates 90 degrees in vertically, and in turn it is connected to a vertical handle. Once the handle is moved, the operating rod will be moved away, and there is isolation takes place between these two insulator, thus the air brake switch will work. So these air brake switches basically used in 11 kV system, that is in double pole or 4 pole structure or 11 kV substations, and they can be operated for low currents. For high currents these cannot be operated. So these isolators has to be closed after opening the circuit breaker only. So these isolators should not be opened until unless circuit breaker cannot be opened, because they are not meant for higher currents. Let us see about the knife switch. Knife switch, in our electrical labs, day-to-day experiments we are conducting, and you all know what is meant by a knife switch. Knife switch also is used either to make or break an electrical circuit, but it is meant for a low voltage. It cannot be used for high voltages, and they are designed for 230 volts or 440 volts, available in single phase and double pole as well as triple pole. And the isolator knife switch is made of like a knife type of blades, and for three types of blades will be there. They are connected to one operating handle which is insulated, and a knob will be there. So through this knob we can operate all these three knives, that is three pole. So for the double pole, two knives will be there. We all seen in our electrical labs. So these knife switches are used to make or break an electrical circuit, designed for low voltage and manually operated. They are not automatically operated, they are only manually operated, but designed for low voltages. These knife switches cannot be used for higher voltages. Let us see more about the isolators. So isolators play important role in power system. For all the switching operations, the isolators are used. Isolators are used from right from 11 kV, that is 11,000 volts to 400 kV substations. And isolators will have a single pole, double pole and triple pole. These isolators are used for the higher voltages but no current conditions. So this cannot be used for the full load conditions. They are also called as the disconnecting switches. They can be manually operated or they can also be automated. They can also be operated automatically by atomizing. So let us see what is meant by an isolator. Isolators operates under no load or no current conditions. They cannot be operated under the full load conditions. They have to be operated under no load or no current conditions. They are also called as disconnecting switches. They just disconnect the equipment or isolate the equipment. That is why they are called as disconnecting switches, designed to make or break the electrical circuit. So if you open, then it breaks the circuit. If you make, then it makes the circuit. That means circuit will be operated. So they are designed to make or break the electrical circuit. The types of isolators. Based on number of poles, the isolators are based on single pole isolators, double pole isolators, triple pole isolators. So what is meant by an isolator? Single pole isolators. So this is a single pole isolator, single pole isolator, and this is a double pole isolator, which is used for two phases or for a single phase neutral. And this is a fuse. This is a switching operation, and the supply will be given to the fuse. Supply will be taken from the switch. So once the switch is closed, that means supply will be coming from incoming to outgoing. So outgoing is connected to apparatus, so apparatus works. So if it is connected to a single phase, it is called as a single pole. If it is connected to a two phase or single phase neutral, it is called as double pole isolator. Now this is a three pole isolators, fuse switch fuse unit. Generally it is called triple pole switch fuse isolator. In a box it is mounted, three fuses and three switches simultaneously. It operates through a common operating wire which is connected to handle. Once a handle is put down, the switch is open. When the handle is moved up, the switch is closed. When the switch is closed, the supply from three phases, it goes to the load for three phases. So then the equipment will be operated. So like this, the isolators are designed for single pole and double pole as well as triple pole. So based on the medium, types of isolators. Isolators based on service, they have been designed as indoor isolators which are not exposed to atmosphere. If they are not exposed to atmosphere, then they are called as indoor isolators. Outdoor isolators which are not exposed to atmosphere, which are exposed to atmosphere, then they are called as outdoor isolator. So indoor isolator and according to service, the isolators has been designed indoor isolators as well as outdoor isolators. What is meant by an indoor isolator? If the isolators are mounted inside the roof or inside the building, then we can say it is an indoor isolator. Or if the isolators are mounted outside the building, exposed to the atmosphere, then we can say outdoor isolator. Outdoor isolators will have a specific design because they have to be exposed for all the weather conditions, that is rainy seasons, winter seasons, etc. So it has to withstand for all these seasons. So the equipment should be sealed so that no water should be enter into the contact. Then the short circuit will not occur. So these isolators are designed for indoor isolators as well as outdoor isolators. So isolators basically used in all the substations where 11 kV to 400 kV substations. So these isolators cannot be opened until unless circuit breakers are opened. Isolator must be opened before the circuit breaker must be opened. Similarly, it must be closed after closing the circuit breaker. So therefore, the circuit breaker must be opened before opening the isolator. And the isolator will have a two insulators or three insulators. If it is a single brake, two insulators. If it is a double brake, three insulators will be there. Let us see details about the isolators. Now, what is meant by an earthing isolator? Earthing isolators connected between line conductor and earth. It is connected between line conductor and earth. Normally, it is open. Earth isolator, normally it is open. Main isolator opens, earth isolator closes. Main isolator opens, earth isolator closes. It discharges the trapped voltage from line to ground. So, earth isolators are different from the main isolators. Earth isolators are connected between line to ground. When main isolator opens, earth isolator must be closed. When main isolator closed, earth isolator must be opened. So, what is the function of earth isolator? In main line, when the main isolator opens, still there will be some voltage existing in the line due to the capacitance effect between line to ground. So, due to this capacitance effect, always there will be a charging voltage available in the line even though the main isolator is open. In high voltage system, these charged voltages also play a very significant role. So, before doing the maintenance, after opening the main isolator, the earth isolator has to be closed so that this trapped voltage or charged voltages will be bypassed to the ground. So, if they are bypassed to the ground, then maintenance can be done. So, without closing the earth isolator, if the operator goes for maintenance on the line, so he feel a very big heavy shock. So, therefore, there is a, for nowadays, always the automatic interlocking system is available. As soon as the main isolator opens, earth isolator will be closed, or with the main isolator closed, earth isolator will be opened. Let us see with the figure. So, this is the main line, this is the main isolator, it is closed. Now, earth isolator, this is the earth isolator connected to the ground, line to ground through the isolator switch. So, normally the earth isolator will be open when the main isolator closes, so that the current from incoming passes to the outgoing and the equipment will be supplied to the equipment. So, now the current will not be passed to the ground. The main purpose is the current should go to the equipment. It will not bypass to the isolator because here the earth isolator is open. Normally, earth isolator opens when main isolator is closed. Let us see with the another figure. Main isolator opens, earth isolator closes. So, this is the supply and main isolator is feeding to the supply. Now, main isolator opens. When the main isolator opens, now you can see here the earth isolator is closed. When the earth isolator is closed, whatever the trapped voltages are there, that will be bypassed to the earth isolator to the ground. Now, from where the trapped voltage will exist? So, always there is a capacitance effect between line to ground. This is the ground, this is the line. So, there is a capacitance effect. C is the capacitance. There is a capacitance effect. Due to this capacitance effect, always there will be a charging voltages. So, these voltages must be bypassed through the earth isolator to the ground. So, therefore, generally when this is open and earth isolator closes, when the main isolator closes, earth isolator will be open. Now, let us see working of an isolator. The working of isolator, the isolator arrangement is such that one stack swings clockwise and at the same time the other swings counterclockwise. That means one stack, one insulator swings clockwise and at the same time the other swings counterclockwise. The contact arms swings is horizontal plane and the isolation takes place at the center. So, these are the two insulator posts. And above this is metallic contacts to receive incoming supply, and these are metallic contacts to receive the to send the outgoing supply. These two insulators are mounted on the steel frame. Let us see more about this with the real figure. This isolator will have two insulator posts. these two are insulator posts, and over this insulator post metallic end caps are there to receive the supply. This is to receive the supply, this is to send the supply. Now these two insulators are mounted on the bearings. Here these are the bearings, and these two insulators moves vertically. This moves vertically, this also moves vertically, but one insulator moves clockwise direction, the other insulator moves anti-clockwise direction, about 90 degrees vertically. So that means this insulator moves in clockwise direction, the arrow mark has been shown, and this insulator moves in the anti-clockwise direction, here also the arrow mark has been shown. Both are mounted on a bearing, vertically rotates 90 degrees on a frame, and in turn this frame is mounted on a pole. In turn they are mounted on a pole, and they are connected to an earthing. This is connected to an earthing, and this is an horizontal operating rod which connects between these two metallic parts, and here the isolation takes place in the middle. So that is why it is named as horizontal break or center break. The breaking will be horizontal and the center. That is why they are named as horizontal break, center break, isolators. So here during the normal operation, the supply will be coming to one of the insulator, and from the operating rod, it goes to the second insulator, then it is connected to an equipment. So these two insulators are mounted for a single pole. Like this, for double pole 4 insulators will be there, for triple pole 6 insulators will be there, for single break, if the double break, one more insulator will be coming extra. So now in single break, so it is for single pole, like this 3 sets will be there. All 3 sets are connected to a common operating handle through the mechanical mechanical system. So for isolation purpose, this vertical rod will be moved. Once the vertical rod is moved, then immediately isolation takes place here, and because one is rotating clockwise, the other one is rotating anti-clockwise, so therefore one will be moves clockwise, the other will be moves anti-clockwise direction, here the isolation takes place. So like this, the isolators are either connected to single pole or double pole, triple pole, but for HT purpose always triple pole isolators will be used. So all triple pole, these operating rods, simultaneously they will be opened and simultaneously they will be closed. So for that, a mechanical interlocking will be there, and this mechanical interlocking, in turn it is connected to a vertical operating handle system, and this handle we can operate either manually or we can operate by connecting electric motor mechanism or some hydraulic system, because they are heavily loaded equipment, they cannot be simply operated through the manually. Now here this is a double break. So here either side 2 insulator posts are there, but these two are fixed, and only this middle insulator, it rotates and it is connected to an operating handle system, and this can be used for the two-way connections or for single phase connections, or single connection also it can be used. So here this only vertical middle insulator moves vertically, these two are fixed. So when it moves and it makes the contact, and when an isolation also takes place here, this is the double break isolators used for 220 kV or 400 kV substations. And let us see more about the circuit breakers. What is meant by a circuit breaker? A circuit breaker can be operated manually, and automatically it can disconnect the supply if any abnormal situation occurs in electrical circuit. So in circuit breakers, in place of isolators and knife switches and air brake switches, the circuit breakers play important role. The earlier what we have studied, they do not have making capacity or braking capacity. So what is meant by a making and braking capacity? During the faulty conditions also, the switches supposed to withstand, but they cannot withstand. But circuit breaker will have that facility. That means during rupturing conditions or during the faulty conditions also, circuit breakers can operate. So circuit breakers can be operated even under abnormal conditions also. Let us see the definition part of the circuit breaker. Circuit breaker can make or break the electrical circuit manually. They can make or break the electrical circuit manually. Can be operated at all loads, that is no load, full load and short circuit conditions. So you can see here the facilities for circuit breakers. It can be operated at all loads. At no load we can operate, at full load we can operate, and at short circuit conditions also circuit breaker can be operated. If fault occurs, circuit breaker automatically disconnects the circuit. So we need not wait. If fault occurs, automatically circuit breaker disconnects the circuit. Now you can see the circuit breakers. Different types of circuit breakers has been shown here, and these circuit breakers are called miniature circuit breaker because they are used for low voltages and lighting or for motor control operation. So now this is a circuit breaker. This is a single pole circuit breaker. It is used for single phase. It is used for single phase supply, and it can be operated for single phase. The one is incoming, one is outgoing. Similarly, you can see this figure. It is used for a double pole. Here, like this, two MCBs are there. Two circuit breakers are there, and a common operating handle will be there. Simultaneously, we can operate these two. So this is used for either single phase supply for phase and neutral, or it can be used for a two phase supply. Now you can see here, this is a three phase circuit breaker or triple pole circuit breaker. It has got three circuit breakers like this, 1, 2, 3, and all three are connected to an operating rod. Simultaneously it can make or it can break the circuit. So now here, so this is a phase 1, this is a phase 2, this is a phase 3. All three phases can be operated simultaneously. Now you can see here, this is a 4 pole circuit breaker. It has got 4 terminals. That is, this can be used for a 3 phase and neutral system, where 3 phase and neutral system is required. So this is a phase 1, this is a phase 2, this is a phase 3, this is for neutral. So like this, this can be operated for 3 phase and neutral system. Let us see principle of a circuit breaker. The circuit breaker will have a fixed contact and moving contact. Fixed contact will be connected to a supply, and moving contact should be connected to a load. And during the normal operation, fixed and moving contact will be intact. They will have a contact so that the supply comes to the fixed contact and goes to the moving contact. From there it enters into the equipment or to the load. So whenever the moving contact moves away from the fixed contact, then isolation takes place. Let us see the principle of a circuit breaker. A circuit breaker mainly consists of a fixed contact and a sliding contact into which moves a moving contact. The end of the moving contact is attached to a handle. The end of the moving contact is attached to a handle, which can be manually operated or automatically it can be operated. Now, this circuit breaker will have a fixed contact which is connected to incoming supply, and again moving contact which is connected to a load. Output means it is a load. And the moving contact end will be connected to an operating handle system. Once the handle is moved, the fixed contact will be separated from the moving contact. So now here, the fixed contact and moving contact are touched each other. Therefore, the supply comes into the fixed contact and enters into the moving contact. Then it goes to the load. So this is during the normal operation. When the fault occurs, now you can see the bottom of the figure. The fixed contact and moving contact, they are separated each other. Fixed contact is always fixed, only moving contact moves. So when the moving contact moves from the fixed contact, now here isolation takes place. Therefore, the equipment will be isolated. Thus, the supply will be disconnected up to the fixed contact. The supply will not go to here. So during the faulty conditions, the moving contact will be separated from the fixed contact. During the normal condition, the fixed contact will be intact with the moving contact. Let us see the schematic diagram of a circuit breaker. This is a schematic diagram of a circuit breaker. Now this is connected. Hello? Incoming is connected to, yes.
Sir, question,
yes.
Where is the isolator will be used?
The earth isolators are used in substations from 11 kV to 400 kV lines, and they are connected from line to ground to discharge the trapped voltages from the line. Now let us see the circuit diagram of the circuit breaker. This incoming is connected to a fixed contact. It will have two contacts, fixed contact and moving contact. This moving contact moves into a sliding contact. This red one is sliding contact, and this moves into the sliding contact, and the end of the moving contact is connected to a handle. This handle is automatically operated by an automatic mechanism system. Here it is an automatic mechanism system. Through this system the handle will be operated, and from the moving contact it is connected to an equipment, and through the CT, and the secondary of current transformer is connected to an trip coil system. This trip coil system is automatically interlocked with the automatic mechanism system and handle. Trip coil, handle and this automatic mechanism system. During the normal condition, the current enters and enter into the fixed contact. From there it goes to the moving contact, from the moving contact to the equipment, that is outgoing. So this time the current which is flowing through the CT induces an EMF in the current transformer. The EMF is not sufficient to energize the trip coil, therefore the handle will not be moved. That means during the normal condition, normal EMF will be induced, and this normal EMF is not sufficient to energize the trip coil, therefore the handle will not be moved. So when the handle is not moved, the fixed contact, moving contact will not be separated from the fixed contact. This is during the normal condition. But whenever the abnormal situation occurs, the abnormal situation occurs only in the equipment side. So therefore current flows in the reverse side. Here the abnormal current flows, the abnormal current induces abnormal EMF in this CT, and proportionate EMF will be transferred to the trip coil, and therefore now the trip coil is sufficient to energize. So now the trip coil will energize. Once it energizes, then immediately it moves the handle. Once the handle is moved, that means the moving contact will be separated from the fixed contact. Once it is separated from the fixed contact, thus the isolation takes place here. Yes, please.
Where is the, what is the air brake switch?
Air brake switch is used for a full load conditions and for low current conditions. They are used for pole mounted substations, and they are manually operated. They can be used as a disconnecting switches in pole mounted substations. Now, so this is a schematic diagram of a circuit breaker. During the normal conditions, normal EMF, trip coil will not energize. Therefore, the moving contact will be intact with the fixed contact, and equipment will be run safe condition. When there is a fault at the equipment, abnormal current flows, therefore the EMF induced in the CT is sufficient to energize the trip coil, and the trip coil will energize, and automatically it is interlinked with the handle. The handle will be moved. Once the handle is moved, then the isolation moving contact will be separated from the fixed contact. Once it is separated, the arc is established between the fixed contact and moving contact. This arc establishes either in the oil, that is oil circuit breaker, or in the air circuit breaker, or in the vacuum, that is vacuum circuit breaker. And this medium, that is either oil or air, they form like a high resistance spark, and they quench the arc inside the chamber itself. So this is a schematic diagram of a circuit breaker. Now you can see the definitions part of this. Under normal working condition, the EMF induced in the secondary winding of the CT is not sufficient to energize the trip coil for operation.
Hello.
Yes, please.
What type of oil will be used in the circuit breaker, sir?
In the circuit breaker, transformer oil will be used. We cannot use any other oil because they are flammable oils. Transformer oil is a non-flammable oil. So under normal working condition, the EMF induced in the secondary winding of the CT is not sufficient to energize the trip coil for operation. But under faulty conditions, abnormal current flows in the primary of CT induces sufficient EMF in the secondary circuit to energize the trip coil. so as to release the handle, hence the circuit is disconnected. So the circuit breaker operates only under the fault condition. Under fault conditions, abnormal current flows, so therefore sufficient EMF in the secondary, therefore trip coil energizes, hence circuit is disconnected. What are the different types of circuit breakers? The different types of circuit breakers are bulk coil circuit breaker, air blast circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers and water circuit breakers. So let us see the different types of circuit breakers. The types of circuit breakers: oil circuit breakers, bulk oil circuit breaker called as BOCB, minimum oil circuit breaker, they are all called as MOCB circuit, minimum oil circuit breaker, sulfur hexafluoride circuit breaker called SF6 circuit breaker, sulfur hexafluoride, vacuum circuit breaker called VCB, air blast circuit breakers ABCB. Again, these air blast circuit breakers are classified into axial blast circuit breakers, cross blast type circuit breakers, radial blast type circuit breakers. So these circuit breakers will have two contacts, fixed contact and moving contact, and this fixed and moving contact, if they operate in the oil, then we can say bulk oil, oil circuit breaker. If the oil is used more, that is bulk oil. If the oil is used very less, then it is a minimum oil circuit breaker. In place of oil, this fixed and moving contact operates in the SF6 gas, then we can name as SF6 circuit breakers. Or if the circuit breaker fixed and moving contact operates in the vacuum, then they are called as vacuum circuit breakers. Similarly, if the circuit breaker operates in a air blast, then it is a air blast circuit breaker. In air blast circuit breaker, while moving contact separated from the fixed contact, the arc establishes, the arc will be blasted through the air effect, that is why they are named as air blast circuit breaker. If the blasting is axial, then it is an axial blast. If the blasting is radial, that is a radial blast. If the blasting is cross, or that is 90 degrees vertically to the arc, then it is a vertical blast, cross blast circuit breakers. So these circuit breakers play important role. They will have a making capacity as well as breaking capacity, whereas isolators, knife switches, air brake switches doesn't have. So always the circuit breakers are connected to a load. The system will be like this. The supply will be coming to the air brake switch or an isolator. From the isolator, it is connected to a circuit breaker. From the circuit breaker, supply is connected to a load. So before disconnecting the load, first the circuit breaker must be open, because they are meant for a higher load conditions. It can be open for all the load conditions, that is low load, under full load, as well as even faulty conditions also. Therefore, before disconnecting the load, first the circuit breaker must be open. After opening the circuit breaker, the isolator must be open. We cannot open the isolator before opening the circuit breaker. The circuit breaker must be open first, then isolator must be open. While closing or while connecting the load also, first the isolator must be closed. After that, the circuit breaker must be closed, so that directly the load is connected to the circuit breaker. Now we will have a brief summary. Today the discussion was about the AB switch. Oh? The AB switch, yes.
What is a circuit breaker, sir?
Circuit breaker is used as a disconnecting switch or to make the connections, but it can be operated all load conditions, even full load conditions, no load conditions, under faulty conditions. The circuit breaker can be operated under abnormal conditions also, because if the fault occurs in the circuit, automatically trips. Once it trips, unknowingly also we can make the circuit breaker on. Even then also, again circuit breaker will fall, but equipment will not be damaged. So this is the advantages we will have compared to the AB switch, knife switch, isolators. Let us have a question answers session. Why switchgear installation is needed? Switchgear installation is needed either to receive electrical power, B. To distribute electrical power. C. To receive and store electrical power. D. To receive and distribute electrical power. A. The switchgear can be used to receive the electrical power. Correct. This can be used to distribute the electrical power. Correct. To receive and store electrical power. It can receive, but we cannot store the electrical power. D. To receive and distribute the electrical power. Here A and B are correct, but D is the most correct because it can be used either to receive or distribute the electrical power. What is the sequence of operation of isolator? Sequence of operation of isolator, circuit breaker and earth switch. A. Earth switch opens, isolator opens, circuit breaker opens. B. Earth switch closes, isolator opens, circuit breaker opens. C. Circuit breaker opens, isolator opens, earth switch closes. D. Isolator opens, earth switch closes, circuit breaker opens. C. Circuit breaker must be opened because it is connected to the load. Then isolator must be opened. When the isolator opens, automatically earth switch closes so that the trapped voltage discharges to the ground. So here the C is the correct answer out of A, B, C, D. What type of oil will be used in oil circuit breakers? What type of oil will be used in OCB? A. Diesel oil. B. Castor oil. C. Transformer oil. D. Synthetic oil. Diesel oil, it is a flammable oil. Castor oil, it is also flammable oil. D. Synthetic oil, this is also flammable oil, but they do not have any dielectric strength. So therefore, the transformer oil, C is the correct. Transformer oil will be used in oil circuit breakers. Isolators are used mainly for providing. The beginning I expressed, isolators are used only for doing the maintenance. For maintenance, the isolator must be opened. So therefore, isolators are used mainly for providing maintenance. We have to fill up this blank with the maintenance. How many post insulators used per phase in the isolator? How many post insulators used per phase in the isolator? A. 1, B. 2, C. 3, D. 4. I told you in the beginning, in isolators, for a single break, 2 insulator will be used. For double break, 3 insulator will be used per phase. For phase, 2 insulator. For 3 phase, 6 insulator. Therefore, here the post insulators used per phase in the isolators are B. 2 is correct. This is of course for single break. The switch that is operated only under no load conditions. The switch that is operated only under no load conditions. A. AB switch. B. Oil circuit breaker. C. Air blast circuit breaker. D. Isolators. Under no load conditions, AB switch will be used for full load conditions. Oil circuit breaker, air blast circuit breaker can be used for all load conditions. No load, full load, faulty conditions. D is the correct answer. Isolator will be used to operate under no load conditions. What is a earth isolator? Connected between line conductor and earth. Normally it is open. Main isolator opens, earth isolator closes. It discharges the trapped voltage to ground. The earth, here the function has been asked. What is the earth isolator? It is of course connected between line and earth. Normally it is open. Main isolator opens, earth isolator closes. But the function of earth isolator is it discharges the trapped voltage to ground. So we will continue about the classification of circuit breaker and where the circuit breaker will be used and the construction principle and operation of circuit breaker in the next class.